How do you like it so far?
Seen dead with a living work of art.
Nowadays, a fact is what has been translated into words of images. Those qualities, these forms to combine facts abstractly upon opinion, public face is wit.
Drop this jiggery pokery and talk straight turkey. The word is out.
Goes without saying.
I'm not too often concerned about this.
Medium is the massage. The medium is the massage. Marshall McLuhan, Marshall McLuhan.
Yeah, how about that?
There'll probably be some music, but we'll manage to find a quiet corner where we can talk.
Professor McLuhan is...
Our time is a time for crossing barriers, for erasing old categories, for probing around. When two seemingly disparate elements are imaginatively posed, put in apposition in new and unique ways, startling discoveries often result. Medium of our time,
electric circuitry,
profoundly involves men with one another. Information pours information. As soon as information is acquired, very rapidly replaced by still newer information. Our electrically configured world has forced us to move from the habit of data classification. No longer mode of pattern series. Recognition, block by block. We can no longer step build serial, block by block, step by step, because instant communication ensures that all factors of the environment and of experience coexist in a state of active intellect. Active intellect.
There ain't no grammatical errors in a non-literate society.
All media work us over completely. They are so pervasive in their
personal,
political,
economic,
aesthetic,
psychological,
moral,
ethical,
and social consequences that they leave no part of us untouched, unaffected, unaltered. The medium is the massage.
The medium is the massage.
Any understanding of social and cultural change is impossible without a knowledge of the way media work as environments.
Everything we do is music.
What you expect McLuhan will be doing once he's there next year or later this year?
There's a friend of mine at Fordham who's on the faculty, and he's writing a booklet called What to Do Until McLuhan Comes. Yeah. Nice. We can't.
The French make a distinction. This is
I believe enough. It. I really believe it.
For another program.
But what he's done, it's kind of incredible and things like that. Because he's a very unlikely.
Until writing was invented, man lived in acoustic space, boundless, directionless, horizonless, in the dark of the mind, in the world of emotion, by primordial intuition, by terror. Speech is a social chart of this bog.
The wrath of Achilles is my theme.
That fatal wrath which in fulfillment of the will of Zeus brought the Achaeans so much suffering and sent gallant souls of many noblemen to Hades, leaving their bodies as carrion for the dogs and passing birds. Let us begin, goddess of song, with the angry parting that took place between Agamemnon, king of men, and the great Achilles, son of Peleus.
Which of the gods was it that made them quarrel? Agamemnon, king of men.
Structures and overall patterns in lure easy procedure.
The discovery of the alphabet will create forgetfulness in the learner's soul, because they will not use their memory.
We don't know who discovered water, but we're pretty sure it wasn't the fish.
I believe it. I really believe it.
The goose quill put an end to talk. It abolished mystery. It gave architecture and towns. It brought roads and armies, bureaucracy. It was the basic metaphor with which the cycle of civilization began. The step from the dark into the light of the mind. The hand that filled the parchment page built a city.
We shape our tools. And thereafter our tools, epos!
Whence did the wondrous mystic art arise? Of painting speech and speaking to the eyes. That we, by tracing magic lines, are taught how to embody and to color thought.
Writing did not merely record language. It was a totally new medium of expression and communication which the spoken word came in turn to imitate. Writing encouraged an analytical mode of thinking with emphasis upon linearity.
Once more, please.
The trouble is I keep thinking of improvements on these passages all the time. With emphasis upon linearity, continuity, and connectedness. In other words, visuality.
Where is A? It precedes B. And B follows A and precedes C.
Writing was an embalming process that froze language. It eliminated the art of ambiguity and made puns the lowest form of wit.
Should all the quietness be forgot?
The expert is the man who stays put.
Soon all that will be required of us will be 1 hour's work a year.
Writing destroyed word linkages.
Might
the
be a word.
Simultaneous interrelation between many levels
instance,
of meaning
Marshall
the word have to be sacrificed
says that
to keeping everything moving on a single plane on one level. The word became the static symbol, applicable to and separate from that which is symbolized. It now belonged to the objective world. It could be seen. It was a thing. Now came the distinction between being and meaning.
Baby, this thing is bigger than all of us.
Often we don't know what we think until a question is put to us.
Says that all he's doing is describing, not...
John? John who?
Doesn't make very many value judgments or suggestions about what people should do about these things.
Show me something new.
For instance,
new.
Marshall himself says that
again.
All he's doing is describing, not prescribing.
Every new technology creates a new environment in which men live and work. The technology of the alphabet and of movable type... Printing, 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 printing. Predisposed us to think and act in certain ways. Printing extended the emphasis upon linearity. It fostered and encouraged a fragmenting process. A process of specialism and of detachment, a habit of thinking in bits and parts, and step by step. Printing completely changed everything. It changed what men thought of themselves, how they behaved toward each other. It changed systems of government, and so on, and so on, and so on.
And so on, and so on, and so on.
You know, the most favorable moment to seize a man and influence him is when he's alone in the mass.
Printing technology confirmed and extended the new visual stress. It provided the first uniformly repeatable commodity, the first assembly line, mass production. It created the portable book, which men could read in privacy and in isolation from others. Men could now inspire and conspire. It was the print-oriented genius of the Western world that created an applied knowledge and technology unrivaled in human history, and learned to manipulate matter, energy, and human life by breaking down every useful process into its functional parts, then producing any required number of each part.
You're feeling like you was lost in the bush, boy?
Just as pre-shaped parts became components of, say, an airplane, human specialists became components of a great social machine.
Compartmentalization of occupations. Compartmentalization of occupations and interests bring about. Compartmentalization of occupations and interests bring about a separation of that mode of activity.
Okay. Clocking it at $40,000 a year. Coming up to Marshall with a copy of the book in their hand, asking for an autograph with absolutely the same degree of abandon and awe that they would go to Willie Mays.
The Balinese have a saying: we have no art. We do everything as well as we can. As we move into the world of integral, computerized knowledge.
But on your right, the lovely remastered mending grounds where 1963...
Mere classification becomes secondary and inadequate.
Each of these entities is then assigned its own place in which it must reside.
Mere classification becomes secondary and inadequate to the speeds with which data can now be processed. We are moving out of the world of data classification into the world of pattern recognition.
The highest purpose is to have no purpose at all. This puts one in accord with nature and harmonious operation.
Why did the Mormon take a ladder to church?
Like easel painting, the printed book added much to the cult of the individual. The private fixed point of view became possible. Literacy conferred the power of detachment, of non-involvement. There's a story which illustrates the kind of pun that is not customary in literary society.
David Ogilvy, the advertiser.
The story of the Boy Scout who helped a nun across the street.
Tends to begin all his memos with...
And the nun thanked the lad, who replied, "That's all right, madam. Any relative of Batman's a friend of mine." The visual pattern of the sculptured costume, starched costume of the nun, bears a certain structural relation to Batman's costume, so that the strange bridge between the nun and Batman is a bit of pattern recognition or visual punning. Visual punning, as opposed to mere verbal punning, is something that is beginning to happen again in our electronic time, and it is one of the pet activities of Eskimos. They delight in spotting visual puns in the ordinary environment in various materials.
Such as?
Stone. They delight to see a configuration in a stone that resembles a walrus tusk or a...
Do you like your job, Professor McLuhan?
America was able to develop and apply swiftly all the consequences of printing in the book, the newspaper, and by extension the assembly line in industry and organization and markets, because there was no backlog of obsolete technology to be liquidated first. Europeans had to struggle through a long, painful period in order to clear enough room to exploit the new print technology.
Quanto è bella la prospettiva.
Okay, now once more with more expression, Irving.
Quanto è bella la prospettiva.
Now hold it. That's part of the script.
Our Renaissance legacy was the vanishing point, the single static viewpoint of the limited optical science of the time. This single piercing view demanded a central point of interest and an undisturbed, restful symmetry to either side of it.
This is the place to see it from, Phyllis.
Good.
The eye, it cannot choose but see. We cannot bid the ear be still. Our bodies feel where'er they be, against or with our will.
Those who write the anatomy of experience...
The alphabet is an aggressive and militant absorber and transformer of culture.
These divisions in here...
The alphabet is an aggressive and militant absorber and transformer of culture.
Nature.
The alphabet is an aggressive and militant absorber and transformer of cultures.
I've never been here before.
Now for the evidence, said the king, and then the sentence. Now, said the queen, first the sentence and then the evidence. Nonsense, cried Alice so loudly that everybody jumped. The idea of having the sentence first.
The alphabet is a construct of fragmented bits and parts which have no semantic meaning in themselves. It must be strung together in a line, bead-like, and in a prescribed order. Its use fostered and encouraged the habit of perceiving all environment in visual and spatial terms, particularly in terms of a space and of a time that are uniform, continuous, and connected. The line, that good old reliable continuum, became the organizing principle of life.
Advanced systems of so-called typesetting really get going. Then I think that it would be very, very simple to, and inexpensive, and quite reasonable to simply record conversation.
Yeah.
With all
we habitually say, I don't follow you.
Chopping and groping. Yeah.
The new principle, how does that grab you, is a more involved, multi-sensuous approach to the problem of meaning.
As we begin, so shall we go.
Rationality and logic came to depend on the presentation of connected and sequential facts or concepts. For many people, rationality still has the connotation of uniformity and connectedness. I don't follow you means I don't think what you're saying is rational. How does that grab you?
I still don't follow you.
Indeed, even our tests for sanity often assumed that the line is present in nature and must be discovered or given visual existence.
Typography cracked, the voices of silence.
Take it easy, but take it.
What has been worked over to give it a general character very, very few people can experience directly.
We are proud of our museums, where we display a way of living that we have made impossible.
The railway radically altered the personal outlooks and patterns of social interdependence. It bred and nurtured the American dream. It created totally new urban, social, and family worlds, new ways of work, new ways of management, new legislation.
Conkadook, he'll do.
As the new electric technologies come into play, people are less and less convinced of the importance of self-expression. Teamwork succeeds private effort. Ours is the first age in which many thousands of the best trained minds have made it a full-time business to get inside the collective public mind. To get inside in order to manipulate, exploit, control.
The art of the speaker consists in compressing all of his aims into slogans.
We shape our tools, and thereafter, our tools shape us!
What'll happen when intelligence is recognized as a global resource?